Hey everyone, how it's going? This is Harish Dalal and welcome to our channel CodeChef. So the problem today we'll be solving is qualifying to pre-elimination. It is a cakewalk problem. The prerequisites are sorting. So this problem is taken from past SnackDown round, SnackDown 2019 online qualifier. The problem code for which is QUALPREL. So let's get to the problem statement. So here is the problem definition. SnackDown 2019 is coming and there are two rounds, round A and round B. After the qualification round, from both of them, teams can qualify to pre-elimination round. So this is the rule for the qualification. In each of these two rounds, teams are sorted in descending order, means from greater to the smallest order of their score. Means 6 will come first and then 5, then 4 and so on. And each team with a score greater or equal to the score of the kth place advances to the pre-elimination round. So let me explain this statement here. So for example, if the teams that scored, the score of the teams are like 6, 5, 4, 3, 3 and 2, 1. So these are the scores of 7 teams. And we have to see how many teams will be qualifying for pre-elimination round. So the k will be given, means k is given. So according to the rule, whoever team had scored the score greater than or equal to the kth team in descending order will be qualifying to pre-elimination round. So for example, if the k here is 3, the third, so let's take the third team is this. So whoever team has scored greater than or equal to score 4 will be qualifying to pre-elimination round, means this all teams, means this, the starting three teams will be qualifying to the pre-elimination round. Let's take another example. If the k here is 4, means this is the fourth team. So whoever team had scored greater than or equal to score 3 will be qualifying for pre-elimination, which is this much. So these 5 teams, 6, 5, 4, 3 and 3, these 5 teams will be qualifying for pre-elimination round. And we have to find the number of teams that will qualify for pre-elimination round. Let's take another test case. So the test case given in the problem is n is 5 and k is 1 and the score of all the 5 teams are 3, 5, 2, 4 and 5. So first of all, we have to arrange this in descending order. So 5, 5, 4, 3, 2. And the score of the first team is 5. So it states that whoever team has scored greater than or equal to 5 will be qualifying for pre-elimination round. So these two teams have scored greater than or equal to 5. So these two teams will be qualifying for pre-elimination round. So the answer for this test case is 2. Now let's see the approach to this problem. So first of all, we'll be taking t test cases, and for each test case we'll be given two input, n and k. N is the number of teams and k is the qualification criteria, means the score of the k team is the qualification criteria. And for each team, the score is given, like a1, a2, a3. We'll be storing this till an. We'll be storing these scores in an array. Now it is said that we have to sort these scores in descending order, so we'll be using inbuilt function sort, and we will be sorting this array, and we have to pass a parameter to denote, to make sure that this array is sorted in descending order. So let's say it is this. This is just a pseudocode. It is not the actual syntax of any language like C, C++. After sorting, we know that the qualification score is the score of kth team. So just store this in a score variable. If we are using zero indexing, so the kth team is actually k minus 1 team. Means like if our teams are 6, 5, 4, 3, 3, 2, 1, and it is said that the score of the third team is the qualification score, means if we start from the zeroth team, so this is the third team, so the index is 2. So to store the score of the care team, we'll be using k minus 1. And now let's initialize a variable count to store the final answer, means the count of the teams which is qualifying for pre-elimination round. Now let's run a loop for each team. The loop will start from 0 to n, and for each team we'll check whether this team will qualify or not. If it qualifies, we'll increment our count by 1. If the score of current team, which is A of I, is greater than or equal to the qualification score, then we will increment our count by 1. Else we can just break out of loop, because if this team doesn't able to qualify for pre-elimination round, it is obvious that the teams coming further won't be able to qualify for the round, because they are smaller than the score of these teams are obviously smaller than this team. So we can just break out of the loop. And finally, we just have to print the count. So let's move to the coding part now. So I will be implementing this code in C++ language. You can choose any language you want, like C, C++, Java or Python. So first of all, I will be taking t test cases. Now running the loop for t test case. So this, for each loop, the while loop will decrement my t by 1, and until and unless my t becomes 0, this loop will run. Now for each test case, we'll be getting two inputs, n and k. Now we'll be getting n scores for the team. So I will be storing those scores in vector. So you can use bits std C++ library to use the vector. Vector is kind of array. So initializing its size with n. Now I have an array whose size is n. Now I will be taking the scores as the input. This for loop is for taking all the scores as the input. I'm iterating the loop from 0 to n. So as after taking all the scores, we have to sort the array in descending order. And for that, I will be using the sort function, which is included in bits std C++ library. So sort, as the first parameter for sort, we have to pass the first iterator of our vector, which is v.begin. This denotes the first iterator pointing to the first element of our vector, and the second parameter is the just next iterator to our last element, which is v.end. So this is the first iterator pointing to our first element of the vector, and v.end is the iterator to the next of our last element. The third parameter is to denote that we want our list to be in descending order, not in ascending order. So we will be using greater arrow brackets and curly brackets. If you exclude this parameter like this, this function alone will sort our vector in ascending order, but we don't want that, we want in descending order. So we will be including that. Now as we know, our list is sorted in descending order. Next is, we have to store our kth score in a variable. Let's create that variable and store this. Score into our variable. As I said, that we will be taking k minus 1 rather than k, because we are using zero indexing, as our first element is indexed to 0 and the kth element will be indexed to k minus 1. So our kth team will be at k minus 1. Now running loop for n teams, Before that, we have to create a variable count to store the count of the teams which will be qualifying for pre-elimination round. After that, now running the loop for n teams. For each team, we'll be checking whether this team will be qualifying or not. If the score of the current team is greater than or equal to the qualification score, then we will be incrementing our count by 1. Else, we can break out of the loop, as we know that after that, no one will be scoring greater than our qualification score, as the list is sorted in descending order. Finally, we will be printing out our answer, which is in count, and that's it. Now let's break down to the time complexity of this code. As this function, the sort function, takes n log n time to sort any vector, any array. So this will take n log n time. For taking the input, we'll be taking O of n time, and for each team, we are just checking whether this team will qualify or not. So this loop is also taking O of n time. So the largest time taking function is this sort function, and which is our time complexity for this code, O of n log n. So now let's submit this code on CodeChef. Make sure to select the correct language. I'm using C++ 14. So yeah. Before submitting, make sure to test your code by inputting the custom test case here and then clicking on run. I'm submitting the code. So yeah, you got a correct answer. So that's it, guys. From my side, this problem was a practice problem to help you upskill in your Snackdown journey. Snackdown is a highly competitive programming event where coders across the globe participate under the same roof. It is an experience you do not want to miss, and so keep practicing and check out other problems in the mock contest. See you in the next one.